In this GIMP workshop, we will create a text portrait and apply the displacement effect. If you want to follow along, you can find the download link for the image in the video description. Go to File and click Open. Here we search for our portrait image and we open it. Then we go to Layer and click New Layer. Rename it Text. We make the layer fill type white and click OK. Now we are going to change this layer into a text layer. Find on your hard drive the text that you want to use. Select this text. Click Ctrl-C to copy it. Now we go back to GIMP. Zoom out a bit by pressing the Ctrl key and simultaneously rolling the mouse wheel so we have a lot of space around our image. Then we activate the text tool. Make a selection and add a lot of empty space, especially below the image, like shown in the video. Press Ctrl-V to paste the text. When this message pops up, you can just click OK. Press Ctrl-V several times until you are sure that the whole rectangle is filled with text, although it's not visible outside the image. Triple-click inside the text so all the text is selected. This might take a moment. Now we go to the tool options and change the line spacing to -5 or 6. This too can take a little time. Make sure that the text still covers all the white of the image. Click in the text to deselect it. Right-click on the text layer and hit Merge Down so we get one layer. Now we go to the menu bar, click on Layers, and here we hit Layer to Image Size. This is important because both layers need to be of the same size in order to apply the displacement successfully. Go to View, Zoom, and click Fit Image in Window. Click on the downwards pointing arrow to place the text layer below the portrait layer. Select the portrait layer and make a duplicate of it by clicking the Duplicate button at the bottom of the Layers panel. With the top layer selected, we go to Colors and here we click Desaturate. Now just click OK. Displacement works best with a black and white image that has a fairly high contrast. Go to Colors again and now hit Curves. Make the contrast a bit higher, but not too much. Click the Preview button off and on, and then we click OK. Now we go to Filters, Blur, Gaussian Blur. We click and drag the dialog box to the top of our screen and pull it out. Move the image to make it good visible. Then we make the blur radius 10. Click the preview off and on and click OK. Select the text layer. Click on the upwards pointing arrow so it moves up one place in the layer stack. With this layer selected, we go to Filters, Map and click Displace. You can experiment with the X and Y displacement values, but for now we leave them at 20. Click the option Smear. Then click OK. Select the top layer, and because we do not need it anymore, we can delete it by clicking on the waste bin. Select the portrait layer and make a duplicate by clicking the duplicate button. Place the duplicate layer on top of the layer stack by clicking the upwards pointing arrow. Then make it invisible by clicking the eye. Select the bottom layer. Go to Colors and click Desaturate. Go ahead and just click OK. Now we select the text layer. We make the mode of this layer Burn. Then we select the top layer, make it visible, and change its mode to Color. Make the text layer active again. Go to the toolbox and click on the Eraser tool. Leave the brush on hardness 0.75, but make the size about 50. We will erase the text from the background and also from the eyes. Zoom in by pressing the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel. we press the spacebar, we can, by moving the mouse without clicking, move the image. When we make a mistake, we can press and hold the Alt key and paint some text back. With the bracket keys, we can change the size of the eraser. We will go fast forward now. All done. Go to View, Zoom and click on Fit Image in Window. And with that, we have made our own text portrait with an impressive displacement effect. I hope you have fun with this tutorial. If that's the case, please give it a thumbs up. Maybe leave a nice comment and subscribe if you haven't done already to support my channel. Thank you very much for watching.